Hello guys, my name is Russian Badger, and at the starting of this conquest match, I don't know what this guy was thinking. Like, yeah, the guy in the $6,300 suit is gonna lose in a helicopter battle against the guy that doesn't make that in 3 months. Come on, that's not gonna happen. And then all of a sudden I got repaired by Kevlar XD. That guy is a gentleman and a squire, but this guy thought he could get away, but you know what? A perfect line works right here. You buy the ticket, you ride the train, bro cookie, and that train ends up in you vaporizing in midair. I don't know if that's very pleasant, but I was also going to say for great justice just before he perished, but you guys will see the Batman. The Batman, I want to say the Batman makes an appearance later on in this video, but that appearance is so brief. Okay, let's just say it involves breaking patellas and like some sort of crate that he just didn't see coming. I guess the crate came out of nowhere, but if you're excited to see the Batman, he makes a brief appearance later on in the video. And I mean very brief when I say brief, okay? I don't mean it like boxer briefs, but very, very brief. And I did not even mean to kill that guy. I was trying to suppress him. Like, this guy, okay, that's all I want to do, just suppress him. I'm not trying to, he's playing on the jungle gym. I don't know if he thinks those stones are some sort of playground, but they're clearly not. And I got one gentleman accident. I didn't mean to shoot you, bro. I didn't mean to shoot you. I was just... Oh, I got the suppression kill assist, though. That's what I was going for. Just because I really, really, really enjoy being rewarded for missing my target. That is some serious first-person shooter goodness. And look at this. This is the second best way to cap a flag. I don't know my technique here. It's like a rock-a-bye baby on the treetop, back and forth. Maybe I'm just a bad helicopter pilot, but like I said, the second best way to cap a flag, I will show you the best way to cap a flag in just a few seconds here. And I don't know why this team had the hots for the Vodnik. I don't know why they were all about their Vodnik. I just didn't get it. Because I think we all know, it's all about the brick, alright? The brick, oh man. And these guys thought they could get away too. It's like, I blew up your car, it's not like I just forgot about you. Oh, maybe they didn't die. There's one in! The two-piece, but the no biscuit. I'm really sad about that. I'm really sad I didn't get the biscuit. And look at this Badger logic right here. Oh, I'll jump out for 4 meters. I might... No. I still broke my femurs and snapped my tibias. I don't know what logic... That's sort of the... You guys know that Badger logic is not very logical at all. I don't even know why I call it logic. Like, it's not even minutely rational, if you ask me. It's almost like the same train of thought of an elevator. You know an elevator's going, it's like falling from... Maybe like a cord broke or something and it's falling. And Sphincter 1960's got dunked on from above. But, and I don't know if I tried to change the little bird into like a little platypus and make it swim here. But it's, you know, jumping out of a helicopter like I just did from 4 meters. That's sort of the same logic of, oh, I'm jumping out of an elevator from 4 meters. And I think I'm just going to magically not have the same velocity and then break my kneecaps as soon as I hit the ground. I don't know why I was thinking like that. I just didn't have the time to pull out my parachute. And I was worried about, you know, when you're disabled. And the little bird, I had no idea that the little bird chunked the tanks that much. You guys saw earlier on, it was another little bird and I sort of combo. It was like a combo breaker. You're trying to both get that tank that was on a kill streak. And I don't know, it chunks it a lot more than I thought it did. It's not exactly, you know, it's not exactly an attack helicopter in terms of damage, but the little bird definitely does do some serious damage. And these hangers were like the bane of my existence. Despite the fact that the cloth monster here, I was like, oh, I can't make it. And I think I even killed my two other squad mates. And the only thing that I always reply with is, don't worry, I'm a trained professional, when I'm clearly not. And this is the best way to cap a flag in Battlefield 3. And you know, Mr. Scent even enjoyed the ride. Look at that. He's like a small child. Look at this. Whee! I don't know if I'm even trying to make you dizzy right now, but I think this is the most baller way to cap a flag in style. And you know what the insult is? You know what the insult is? We're Americans driving a Vodnik. That's like a slap in the face to all of Russia, which is very funny. And you guys... Oh, Badger, but aren't you I'm not even minutely Russian, and I'm also not a badger. You guys also thought I was a catfish. I'm not any of those things. I'm clearly American, and I'm... Well, I don't even want to give you my biography, because that's boring and dull. It's almost like a pencil. And, okay, this gentleman... Okay, I'm trying to think. Okay, yeah, this is the part where I get taken down. This cloth monster, he's like, the joke's on you, Badger. Look, I'm going to steal your tank now. And then all of a sudden... No, here comes the brick squad. I get revived and they blow up the tank. And the tank is... That's what I don't get. I don't know how tanks just vaporize like that, but this is such a sad story. the vodding that we capped the flag in has got so many historical memories. It helped us cap the flag. It drove us around the map. I was like, I can fix it. We have the technology. We can drive them out. Don't let Bertha die. No. And I just didn't want to let it go. But we just don't have the torque to get up here. I got so sad. It was like, it's like Jack Dawson on the door of the Titanic. And he's just offering it up to whatever her name is. She's not even relevant anymore. But I just said, goodbye, sweet Vodnik. We'll miss you. Despite the fact you're probably going to respawn in the next 20 seconds anyways. It's not the same. It's not the same. But this gentleman, like, this is why I love the Tar so much. All of the little situations where you have to hip fire that it's that one guy versus you and you think he's easily going to destroy you, the Tar pretty much beats him in every situation possible. Pretty much every situation, and this is such a bad moment. This is a moment where you can genuinely say, Badger, you were being very stupid. Okay, enjoy your marshmallows with the M93R, and why did I go around the corner? Why? That was a clearly bad decision on my part. You guys tell that I have 25% health when I went around the corner. Despite the fact he only has 4% health, I almost won the gunfight. I should not have gone around the corner. Obviously 25% health, and I'm just in like a limbo of Mr. Bone's wild ride never stops, and I just keep dying and getting revived and dying, getting revived. But you guys saw, going around a corner trying to get somebody with 25% health, always a bad idea. And Brick Squad, oh man, get dunked on. That guy just got smushed. And then, okay, I back up. I don't even think I smushed this guy, but that is my one and only name that I will never forget for the Amtrak. All this thing is a brick. You're driving a brick, and when you have multiple people also in that vehicle with you, it's called a Brick Squad. And look at this right here. Like a glove. That's like the perfect park job. And I even felt the need to type it in the chat. I don't know why I type in the chat so frequently. It's just something that I really enjoy in Battlefield. I also noticed that I have a lot more spare time in Conquest to type in the chat, and I think the sort of a little bit more social... You can call me, like, Badger, you're such a chatty Cathy. Why don't you just ignore the chat? Well, I find it very rewarding to not so much talk smack against the other team, but just troll them softly. Just like a little nag, like a little get dunked from time to time, or were you planning on shooting me in that engagement? You know when you shoot somebody and they don't get a single bullet on you? Just little things like that. Like, oh, were you planning on firing your gun, or is that just for show? Are you gonna poke me with it? That's a little thing that I like to do. And squeesh! And that's not even the end of it. Like, this brick is so convenient. Like, if I were to name a brick the bit, like, okay, I think about it this way. If I were to name a brick the best brick of all time, I think the Amtrak would be my favorite brick that I've ever set eyes on. Like, even this guy, that's not gonna work, despite the fact, I just don't get why engineers even bother a lot of the time, just because the Amtrak is so meaty. And don't run from me, Carl, don't run from me, Eskvish, he clearly got smushed because he's not wearing the right camo. He should be, I don't know why people even wear other camos other than the blue camo. The navy camo where you look like you're Russian, you're running around in a hoodie that I mentioned previously. It's either that or GTFO, because that is clearly the best camo. And I don't know exactly what I was thinking here, but I tried to, look, they blocked off my escape route. I had this, it's like the Spartans, I had that hidden goat path going out the backside, and then all of a sudden he cut me off and he headshotted me with his pistol. But fear not, this is essentially the part where I think they already knew that they were going to lose, but they had these really squirrely tactics. Like, those guys just got dunked on because they didn't get out of a vehicle that's clearly going to explode in a few seconds. Like, that's one little piece of advice that I can always give you. If you see a crowd of enemies, odds are one of them's going to be an RPG. That doesn't make any sense. Okay, one of them is going to be an engineer, which has an RPG. That's better. Like, what if you, that would be so bizarre if you saw, is my teammate an RPG? Why does an RPG have legs? That would be very goofy. What I was trying to say is, if you see a cluster of enemies and you're driving around in the Vodnik, odds are one of those enemies is an engineer, and engineers carry around rockets that blow things up, and he will easily one-shot you and your Vodnik. So I would definitely get out very frequently and enjoy your marshmallows, Carl number one and Carl number two, but the third one gets me. And fear not, this guy revives me almost immediately, and that is the advantage of running around with a squad. And I also wanted to briefly touch on that. I don't know what that guy just, like, fell over. I don't know if he skinned his knee or what he was doing, but for the most part, I also like to say that I've been trying around the pistols yet again, and I can't really make up my mind. Sometimes the M93R has that, you know, that little weird jamming thing where you're just firing and firing and I'm pulling the trigger, which is supposed to spawn bullets. And look at this guy. Okay, jumping is not going to save you. And go back to Halo, please. And look at that guy. Enjoy your marshmallows, Mr. Snake. Did you see that guy? That cloth monster just sitting in the corner, like slithering. I don't know what he was doing. I think he tried to become a snake for a second. I don't know if he was trying to be a chameleon, but I just... For some reason, my brain, when I saw that guy, I thought he was, like, slithering around. Like, he was trying to slither his way in between the two cargo crates. Like, if he somehow got thin enough, like a thin snake, he could almost get inside there. But I don't know why I found that so funny. But this is one situation right here where I just don't get it. I probably should have lost an engagement. I jumped, just like the guy previously. I jumped, which automatically makes your hipfire go way everywhere. And somehow I still won. And... I even get this gentleman, because running around with your paddles is not a good idea, Carl. That's never really a good idea. For the most part, I like to say, though, that I should... don't copy me, if you will. And I'm not saying don't copy me in, like, any sort of sense, other than don't try to hipfire like I do. I hipfire just because I'm lazy. I don't want to right-click. That's just... Not in the same way, but look at the blue barrel. Come on, Mr. Blue Barrel. Keep going, Mr. Blue Barrel. All these... You are a barrel. Why are you rolling so frivolously? What are you doing? That is the goofiest blue barrel I think I have ever seen. I don't know why he... That inertia. I don't know. The way he was moving was very odd. He would move, and then he would stop, and then he would pause, and then he would have this, like, sudden velocity. I don't know what that blue barrel's deal was, but I think I definitely approve of his conduct. And I would definitely say that... Okay, what I was trying to say is, don't hipfire like I do. I'm a very bad example. Don't try to follow my example. I hip fire when I'm not supposed to, and I should be aiming down sight. But okay, get this guy, look. I'm the goddamn Batman, and broke his knees. Oh, man. For that split second, I thought that guy... I think that guy thought he was the Batman for a few seconds. He came down like, for great justice, and then he broke his knees open. Oh, God. I could not stop. I don't know. I don't even know how I killed that guy. I was laughing so hard at the time. And the two-piece and the biscuit, I'll consider the previous guy that I killed the biscuit. Hey, if that's okay with you. But I just could not stop about that guy. That guy just, for great justice, in mid-sentence, just broke his legs in half. Oh, God. That crate came out of nowhere. I just can't stop thinking about that. At the time, when that actually happened, I'd lost it. I just... I could not stop. I don't even know how I killed the guy immediately after that, because I was like wailing. I was in tears. My tears were flowing like a waterfall. Not in the sense of, like, you know, Justin Timberlake cry me a river, but even this, okay? I think around this point in time is when I regained my composure, when I was done, like, crying into this towel because that was so funny. For some reason, I think that guy thought he was the Batman for a split second. I don't know why I found that so hilarious, but he should be given a cape. That's what DICE should give people. I know DICE gave a, oh, you know those special dog tags DICE approved? I also find it slightly funny that DICE gave them to some of the worst players that I've ever seen. Like, they're not even good players at all. It's like, here, DICE, give away these dog tags to these people that are not all that good so they can easily be taken off of their necks. And believe me, I do not want a set of those dog tags because that would just force more people to chase me around and try to take my sandwich. And I don't really want that at all. And this was some serious crate shenanigans. Okay, I get one gentleman. The Halo jump almost worked. And using, I don't know, man. Using a semi-auto pistol after using the marshmallow gun or, like, the G18, it just feels weird. I don't know, I'm not good at transitioning. I'm not good at that transition of, okay, you've been using the marshmallow gun for the longest time, Badger, here's the M9, and see how you perform, and I get dunked on. Just like this gentleman, the tar, so dandy. Like, I don't think you guys probably count for me, I don't count very much in terms of how much I aim down sight, but I don't approve of your conduct! Give me your sandwich, Cloth Monster! And easily the best part of the match. And it's a great way to end it, if you ask me. I was going to go on a rampage right here, but the game ends just... It's almost like Battlefield 3 just said, Badger, you've had enough. You no longer have the ability to kill anyone else. Just stop it. Go home. Go home, Badger. You are a Badger. Go home. And that is the end of the game. I would like to thank you guys very, very much for watching it again. I think a lot of you know that I am currently on vacation. Like, when I'm making this video right now, it's the 13th, and my flight leaves in a few hours. But when you watch this, it's probably like the 7th? Around that. So I still have yet to, even the previous M16 video, I don't yet have, obviously I can't get your feedback in the future, but please, on this video yet again, let me know if you like Conquest or if you don't like it. I know Rush is what I primarily play, and I've been talking a lot in the past about butthurt admins that keep banning me, but if you would like to see more Conquest, please let me know if you'd like me to revert back to more Rush. You can also let me know that. So I will see you guys next time. Thank you very much for watching. For great justice. Oh, God. That Batman, clip is never going to get out of my head for the next week. But I will see you guys next time. Auf Wiedersehen und bis bald. Und ich bin Heinrich. Ich komme aus Berlin. Und ich bin stark und intelligent. And later. Actually, I have to do one more time because I didn't get enough lisp on. All right. Later.